Hope that you are having a good week. It's hard to believe that in northern Wisconsin here today on October 20th, that it's 70 degrees. What an absolute blessing. What a wonderful place to be. We've been talking about in church on our sermon series. It's entitled Church Glorify God. I truly believe the greatest organization on earth is the church. Now think about what goes on in church, and for the most part, it's filled with folks who are volunteers, folks who have come to be together to worship and glorify God, folks who have different backgrounds, different personalities, who all have their voice and their opinion coming together to serve, to worship, to follow one God. Now it's important to understand that quite honestly, all of us, all of God's children are called by Him. It's God who does the work, if you will, in giving us the faith and calling us to Him. Ephesians 1:4 says, "For He, God, chose us in Him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight. In love, He predestined us for adoption to sonship through Jesus Christ in accordance with His pleasure and will." You could go off in a lot of tangents with that and what that means for us, but the reality is it's God who loves us so much that He's calling us to follow Him, to be His sons and His daughters. And the church is about God. He's the one who calls us. He gives us the faith. He lives through us. He wants to be glorified through us. But as Randy touched on this past week, leaders also have a special role in God's kingdom, in the church. And there is truly a calling, if you will, by God to choose to serve in that leadership position. That would be all leadership positions. Ephesians 4, Paul says, "Christ chose some of us to be apostles, prophets, missionaries, pastors, and teachers so that His people would learn to serve and His body would grow strong." Leadership in general, no matter what capacity, whether that's with children or adults, a small group, teaching, preaching, is God wants to work through us, and He's the one who's gifted us. We'll look at that in a couple of weeks. But as pastors, elders that Randy hit on this past Sunday, it's truly important to understand that role as well as what it is we're doing, what we're getting ourselves into. It truly is not an easy task. But I don't believe it's the most difficult job that there is. Several years ago, leadership guru Peter Drucker, he says that the four toughest jobs in America are the president of the United States, a hospital administrator, a university president, and a pastor of the local church. Having been a pastor for over 35 years now, there's definitely difficulties. There's been struggles. There are many tears that have been shed. There's many hurts that have been felt, but I'm not sure I agree that it is the top four difficult jobs. Now, pastors are on call for the most part 24/7. Pastors deal with a lot of squabbles, of conflicts with people who have strong opinions. Pastors' decisions will be challenged, whether they're big decisions or small decisions. Pastoral work does cut into family time. Being a pastor can carry a negative stigma in our culture today. But I would guess most people, no matter what profession you're in, would say, "You think your job's difficult, walk in my shoes and you'll see how difficult my job is." And I would agree with that. I think no matter what you're doing, there are pros and cons, good and bad areas of our jobs. But as a pastor and elder in the church, it truly is important to understand how important that position, that calling is. 1 Timothy 3 says, "The saying is trustworthy. If anyone aspires to the office of overseer," and we looked at that as pastor, elder, "he desires a noble task." There's something special to be an elder, to be a pastor, that we need to understand. There's something special about serving in God's church. And Christ wants elders to shepherd, to pastor His flock, not under compulsion, but willingly as God would have you. It says that in 1 Peter 5:2. Not because you see it as a duty and an obligation, because you understand what God can and will do through you. Not an easy task. How remarkable that pastoring from an aspiration and delight, not obligation, truly would be what God would want you to be. What a powerful calling. God wants pastors to do the work. He wants elders to happily give of themselves in this emotionally at times taxing work. But He promises to be with us. God in His providence does the decisive work. No matter that's in our family, in our work, or in the church, God starts the process through all of us by giving us a passion, a giftedness, an aspiration, and He affirms that direction through His Spirit's leading that produces fruit through those gifts. And He shows, He confirms that sense of calling, which I think is extremely important to persevere through difficult times, knowing you're called by God to a specific task. I think it's important to remember in Hebrews 13:17, writer says, have confidence in your leaders and submit to their authority. Not because they do everything right, not because they know what's right, but because they're put there by God. And then he says, because they keep watch over you as those who must give an account. Do this so that their work will be a joy, not a burden, for that would be of no benefit to you. I think it's important in the church, a church full of folks who for the most part are volunteers, that we support one another, and including those in leadership. We are all in this together. We all have a responsibility to minister to one another, to be encouragers, to be prayer warriors, that we are in a battle that is obvious in our world today. And we can choose to be that encourager, or we can be a burden and hinder the work of His church. Either way, God will prevail. God will work. And we're excited about what He is doing. And His desire is to work in us and through us, not in spite of us. What a time for us to be a light on a hill for the city, for the world around us to see. Church, this week, glorify God. Thank you.